Starting lineups will begin with the 22nd ranked Wildcats of K-State, Spradling, Foster, Southwell, Owundu, and Gibson. Three kids who come from the state of Texas in that Kansas State starting five. On the other side for the Longhorns, I think Texas surprised some of its fans at least to be 14-4, 3-2 in league play. Taylor, Felix, Holland, Holmes, and big Cam Ridley, who Miles just talked about, the starting five for Texas. As we are just about set to go, the students back in session today, so we've got a nice student crowd is still gathering after the long winter break inside the Erwin Center. We're ready to go, and we have a shirt change for Jonathan Holmes. More than one. So obviously the jerseys have to be adjusted before we start here. The undershirts were not compliant, so they're making those kids take the undershirts off before we get going. Got to get that right, Miles?
Yeah, I think out of all the rules we worry about in college basketball, worrying about undershirts is the least of the worries.
So here we go, the look from straight overhead. Texas coming off a very impressive win, their first top 10 win in more than 3 years against Iowa State over the weekend. Kansas State, Bruce Weber, their head coach, told us maybe their best overall performance over the weekend. They throttled West Virginia, and the Longhorns have the first possession of this game. Freshman Isaiah Taylor, part of that young contingent, the young players playing so well for Rick Barnes.
When you watch this Texas team, a big emphasis, especially in the last game against Iowa State, getting Holmes and Ridley the ball early and often in the painted area.
Texas has size and strength. Holmes will set a screen for Taylor. Kansas State is such a good half-court defensive team. They force a very tough shot, and Gibson with a good box out. Now Marcus Foster from Texas has become a star in his first year for the Wildcats. Way off the mark, but then a miscommunication. The Longhorns lose the ball out of bounds.
Yeah, Marcus Foster, he's been a star so far for this K-State team, leading them in points per game, number two in your black uniforms, 14 points per game, the young man from Wichita Falls, Texas.
Will Spradling, very experienced senior, gets the ball in.
You see Texas going zone off that baseline out of bounds.
Gibson against Ridley. That's a lot of size underneath the basket and the travel.
And there, Ridley just being smart. He's being big. Ridley's not the best athlete that there is as a big man, but has great size. He has length. And just staying long right there affected Thomas Gibson's move on the offensive end.
Well, you've talked a lot about the individual players in this league who have gotten so much better from last season to this season. Ridley is certainly one of those guys. Taking a big step forward. Tough shot. Ridley offensive rebound sticks it back in.
Will Spradling did all he could to try to block out the bigger, stronger Ridley, but Ridley just used his size to advantage on the weak side and able to lay it in.
Spradling versus Ridley, that is not going to be a win for Kansas State.
Something to watch on this end of the floor is this matchup of Holland versus Foster. Holland did an excellent job of limiting DeAndre Kane, one of the best players in the nation, in their last outing on Saturday.
The Wundu contested shot. Gibson grabs the offensive board. Spradling almost daring him to use his left hand.
Bruce Weber asking his guys to move. He wants to run his patented motion offense. Five guys moving, sharing the basketball, always making a cut or screening for somebody.
Shot clock down under 10. Spradling against Taylor. That screen was not very effective. Nice slip pass though to Gibson, who uses the left hand.
Nice catch by Gibson. Gathered himself and went up strong and able to lay it in.
Each team with a bucket now in the first couple of minutes. Jonathan Holmes coming off one of his best games as a Texas Longhorn against Iowa State. Felix, who's a good outside shooter. Spradling tracks down the long rebound.
K-State loves to set those ball screens in transition, especially for Foster. He'll come and look off to be aggressive. And Thomas Gibson, that's about his range right there. Usually he likes to play with his back to the basket, bang down low. But because Ridley has a size advantage on him, steps him out to 15 feet and knocks it down.
Yeah, that's a great sign for K-State if he hits that shot. Taylor, the extra pass, and now they get Holmes a look down low. Southwell there to swat the ball away.
Texas ball.
Here's Thomas Gibson right there, just a dribble handoff. They find him in the post. He faces up. Ridley has his hands down. Ridley made himself a smaller defender there by having his hands down. Then Shane Southwell showing some of his versatility with the block on the other end.
Ridley off the inbound, scores with a foul. Cam Ridley, the sophomore from Houston.
There's just not many teams across the country that has a guy that's 6'9", 285 pounds, has a soft touch like Ridley does. Big hands, long arms. The former McDonald's All-American from Houston, Texas.
Ridley trying to complete the three-point play, and he does. His free throw shooting getting better. And you figure for a guy his size, he's going to shoot a lot of free throws. Southwell looking down low and just led Gibson too far. Turnover for K-State. Just the first few minutes here from the Erwin Center. Holmes hands off to DeMarcus Holland. There's Ridley using that baseline spin move. Good hustle by Holland, but it caroms off to Spradlin. Marcus Foster, the freshman, 0 for his first two in this one. That's a pretty good look for him. He's been scoring a lot of points. Felix right down the lane.
And this is where Texas wants to play, in transition, one shot and done. K-State, one of the best defensive teams in the country. Don't want to let K-State get into a rhythm defensively in the half court. Texas has to make them pay in transition as they did there.
There's Foster off the handoff. Foster draws a whistle. Now that'll send us to our first timeout here in Austin. The Longhorns playing well with an early three-point lead.
Certainly the mindset within the program has changed drastically, and we've got a group of guys that I feel really care about each other. They know they need each other, and they're motivated to help us put this program where we know it deserves to be.
Well, Rick Barnes, the head coach, in his 16th year here in Austin. Dave Fleming, Miles Simon back with you. Miles, this is a program with a lot of proud history, particularly under Coach Barnes. Last couple of years did not go very well. I think they feel good about the way this season has gone.
Well, what a bounce back season. They go 16-18 last year. But when you and I talked to Coach Barnes at shoot-around this afternoon, the first thing he said was putting the program first is the thing that had to change from last season to this season. It's all about Texas and hook 'em horns, and he has guys now that are in there playing for each other first and don't have agendas inside of the locker room.
Yeah, it's easy to see, even those of us who aren't behind the scenes with this Texas team day after day. You can see it on the court. The chemistry, the willingness to play hard, a whole lot different for Texas this season. Marcus Foster from Wichita Falls, Texas, averaging better than 14 a game for K-State in his freshman season.
Foster's a great story. Coach Alvin Brooks, who was coaching at Sam Houston State, knew about Marcus Foster. And then when he got hired on the K-State staff, he told Bruce Weber, this is a guy that we have to go after. And they ended up getting him. Foster was lightly recruited after his senior summer because he had gained some weight, tried to do a position change, but has become a fabulous player here in his first year in a K-State uniform.
Now you see him pull up for the three and hit the three.
And I told you, they want to set those ball screens in transition, especially for Foster, because he's always in attack mode on the offensive end.
Taylor, who was a little bit out of control, I think, that last possession. Horns will run some half court. Felix, Ridley.
Nice rotation there by Nino Williams to pick up Ridley on the pop.
And that's kind of what he does for this K-State team. Number 11 in off the bench, a defensive player, hustle player. Holland with the shot fake. Felix for three. Got it.
Felix is just so much more comfortable, almost in his own skin this year. Had to play point guard last year because Mike Kabongo was out for the first 23 games, but he probably wasn't ready to contribute.
at a high level, but this year much more productive.
And that experience seems to have paid off. Gibson naturally left-handed, in and out. And Williams is going to get called for the foul, pushing to try to get the offensive board. So Nino Williams, his first personal. Texas goes to its bench. Kendall Yancey, the freshman from Richardson, Texas, is in. Connor Lambert, the sophomore from San Antonio, also in for the Longhorns. Texas will use its depth. The big men are asked to run the floor, play that up tempo. Prince Ibe also in off the bench. Leaks thought about another three. Almost Darren Lambert to shoot. He's got a big size advantage against Javon Thomas, but Thomas played him well. Shot clock winding down. Felix has to launch way off the mark. It's an air ball out of bounds. It'll be K-State basketball.
Well, not a great possession there offensively for the Longhorns. Lambert had the advantage there against Javon Thomas, but Coach Bruce Weber said he actually feels comfortable with Thomas guarding bigger guys. As long as he's guarding the ball, he's really strong in that role.
And Javon Thomas, interesting story for the Wildcats. Freshman, had to sit out the first semester, couldn't practice with the team. That was a pretty good pass, not handled though by DJ Johnson, so it's a turnover. Longhorns want to run. Felix, that was a carry. Turnover for Texas.
And that was the right call there. Felix trying to let that ball sit in his hand a little bit. Excellent call by the official.
Kansas State ball.
There is Javon Thomas, the freshman from Queens, New York. And they think he could be a really high-level player for this Kansas State team. Not shooting the ball particularly well, but running the team well. There's Williams. Shot rejected. Just swatted by Prince Ibe.
And there's where Ibe really affects the game on the defensive end. He comes over from the weak side. Great anticipation. He lets the offensive player jump first, and then his timing is excellent on the block.
Averages better than two blocks a game. Only plays 14 minutes a game. So when he's out there, he affects things on the defensive end. He challenged Foster. The long rebound to Texas.
Foster seems to be overly aggressive here in the first half.
Lambert maybe a little overly aggressive, and then Ibe commits the foul against Owundu. And that is a problem for Prince Ibe, the sophomore from Garland, Texas. Parents from Nigeria. He grew up in London, came to Texas to go to school, and still developing as a basketball player. K-State with the ball, down two.
Dave, right now with the freshman Javon Thomas in the game, you'll see a lot more ball screens, a different type of offense when Thomas is in, because he's been limited by less than 20 practices, but more ball screens and more set calls when Thomas is in the game rather than Bruce Weber's motion offense.
Yeah, the motion can take some time to get used to, the timing, the chemistry on the court. Holland, good dish. Ibe hammered, and they'll send Prince Ibe to the free throw line.
I almost would have liked to see Holland shoot that basketball. Prince Ibe, he's an okay finisher around the rim, but let him, if you miss the lay-in, let Ibe be the guy that lays it in.
First of two, Ibe misses badly.
And Dave, as we watch Prince Ibe shoot these free throws, we talked to Coach Barnes this morning. He has a bone problem in his wrist that doesn't allow him to straighten out his hand. He almost has to hold it at an angle. And they said they're lucky, really, if he could shoot the ball straight. And you see two misses there by Ibe.
It's hard to be a good free throw shooter if you can't shoot it straight. And it's literally a physical limitation.
Maybe he should move to the side a little bit more rather than being straight at the basket.
It sounds unusual, but they're searching for a solution for Ibe, who missed them both. 10-10 game. Almost 8 minutes in.
And you
see the Longhorns going zone. Not a ton of shooters on the floor for K-State.
But a really good passer in Javon Thomas, who finds D.J. Johnson.
And that's where Thomas really excels. He's a penetrator, has great vision. 8 assists in their last game versus West Virginia.
8 assists, no turnovers in that game for Thomas. He got crossed over by Felix. Nice move. The tip in is good. Pretty athletic play from Jonathan Holmes.
Yeah, Jonathan Holmes, he's a guy that's always going to bring great effort and great energy. Loves to make all those, do all the little things for this Longhorns team. Soft touch on the tip in.
Amari Lawrence gives it up to Thomas. Spradling in the corner, thought about shooting the three.
Spradling is a guy that really needs to get going and play better for this team.
Southwell has been playing well on the offensive end. But you're right, Will Spradling's been real quiet. He's one of the leaders of this K-State team. The Wildcats on the road, 22nd ranked team of the country, tied with Texas, 12-12. SBN, there's the Erwin Center. They've played basketball inside this building for 37 years, and the facility has held up well over the years on the campus of Texas. And their Longhorns, 14-4, 3-2 in the tough Big 12. You just don't get a break in this conference.
No, you don't. Each and every night it's going to be a tough matchup. Baylor, who's even struggling right now, gave Kansas all they could take last night. Much better spirited effort from Scott Guskod, Oklahoma State, Oklahoma. You go on down the line. Even West Virginia has two of the best scorers in this league in Statton and Harris.
Spradling will shoot the long three. Will Spradling was short there, but Thomas comes away with the carom.
And as I was mentioning earlier, Spradling's a guy, if he can get going and maybe just knock down 2 threes a game, find some type of rhythm on the offensive end, it's really going to provide a boost to this K-State team, especially on the offensive end.
Spradling trying for an opening against that zone.
I'd like to see Southwell get in the high post area.
Thomas a long two, almost banked it in. Lawrence got fouled as he grabbed the offensive board.
And see, not a great possession. They didn't even get the ball inside of the three-point arc. The whole possession, nobody penetrated. And then Thomas, who's a poor perimeter shooter right now, settles for a long contested two.
Bruce Weber's team has gotten so much better since the start of the year till now. And I think particularly on the offensive end, this Kansas State team, it was ugly in the early season on this end of the floor. They've gotten a lot better.
Yeah, and I think part of that is that Shane Southwell was really putting a lot of pressure on himself in the first month and a half of the season. It's his senior year. He felt like he had to be the star and take over on this team. But now he's playing much more relaxed and doing so many other little things. Just like that, he puts the ball on the floor, gets to about 15 feet, and knocks it in. Coming off a 20-point game, Southwell, tremendous improvement over his time in a Wildcat uniform.
You see Javon Thomas, who can really pressure the ball. Taylor tries to go by Johnson. That's a goaltend.
Isaiah Taylor, a guy that Coach Rick Barnes is really high on, leads the team in assists, most free throw attempts and makes, can really penetrate, gets to the rim. Must improve as a shooter. But one thing Coach Barnes says is that this is a young man that's willing to put in the time to get better on a daily basis. He was one of the first guys in the gym today for practice.
Fourth tie here in the first half. Southwell for three. Good rebound for Ridley back in the game.
Nice job by Southwell stopping that basketball and preventing the fast break.
Yeah, just a tiny little play, but it lets the Wildcats set up their half-court defense.
Yeah, and that's where they're the best at. Number one in the Big 12 in points given up and three-point field goal percentage defense.
It's pretty good formula. Trying to enter the ball to Ridley. Taylor couldn't quite do it.
But that wasn't a great angle to feed the post. He's almost in a straight line up the lane line to try to feed him there. You have to get that ball below the foul line area, allow Ridley to get big, and then enter it.
Johnson and Lawrence out. Gibson and Foster back in for Kansas State. So a little more offense now, I think, on the floor for the Wildcats. Shot clock under 15. Thomas right on top of Taylor, who loses it. Out of bounds off of Texas.
And there's where you mentioned earlier, Thomas is such a good on-the-ball defender. He gets low in his stance, has an excellent center of gravity, can move his feet, has excellent lateral movement, and then good hands.
Felix back in, and Texas sets up a little full court pressure. We'll see how aggressive they are with it. Not very.
See, they look a little bit more lost sometimes when Thomas is at the point because they're having to run the sets instead of their motion offense.
Southwell kept that pivot foot down, but the shot clock is already down to 10. Ridley came out and helped knock the ball out of bounds. 7 seconds on the shot clock.
And Dave, it started from the time that Javon Thomas was going to go the wrong way initially on the play. I can hear Bruce Weber scream, the other way, and then Will Spradling wasn't open. So it was a broken play from the start.
Now Foster needs to create something. Shot clock down to 3. Foster down the lane, had it poked away. It's a turnover. And the lead pass into the open court. The layup is good for Martez Walker.
Great look ahead there by Felix. He got his head up and he was able to thread the needle between a couple K-State defenders.
Southwell almost turned it over. Spradling rattles down the 3.
As I talked about, that's what they'll need, some perimeter shooting. That will free some up of the driving lanes for Southwell and Foster.
They are going to say no shot, foul on the floor before the shot, so do not count the basket.
Here's Texas after a good defensive possession. They pick up that loose ball. Felix gets his head up right away and finds Walker streaking down the floor, and he's able to adjust his body and put it up off the glass nice and soft.
It's a point worth emphasizing. Kansas State, the best half-court defense in the Big 12, one of the best in the country. Get those easy baskets before they get set on defense. That's part of the game plan. That is a 5-second violation, a turnover.
Great job by K-State there of denial, made everything tough, but a poor job on the offensive end by the Longhorns. You have to step into your guy's body, create separation, create a lead. You can't just run straight line cuts if you want to get open against denial.
I think part of what Rick Barnes was talking about with his big man, the sophomore Cam Ridley, back to the bench. Southwell.
And here's some of the versatility playing point forward now. He leads the team in assists and block shots.
Foster catch and shoot. No good. Been a tough shooting half so far for the freshman Marcus Foster.
Well, remember, he has a dislocated right index finger. And that was an excellent post-entry pass by Holland to find the big fella, Prince eBay, down low. But Marcus Foster playing with a dislocated index finger that he heard about a week and a half ago can sometimes affect your shooting, especially your follow-through.
Texas back in front. They've had 8 lead changes already. Gibson up and under. Nifty move.
He almost learned from earlier. Remember when he took it into the body of Ridley and Ridley caused them to travel in one of the first possessions of the game. This time he upfakes and steps through and gets the layup.
You see that field goal number, 6 of 8 in the paint for Texas. They'd like to get it in there a little more, I think. Felix, not in the paint, hits it anyway. He's got 8. Texas back up 2. Southwell matched up with Holmes, and then eBay came out to help. Southwell almost banked in the outside shot.
Well, that wasn't a good shot. Prince eBay comes out and contests. He's long, has a great wingspan, and you're going to shoot a contested 3.
eBay also, I think, helped create a possession there for Texas. Ball goes out of bounds off of K-State and sends us to a timeout. Longhorns at home, up by 2. Dave Fleming, Miles Simon back here in Austin, and Miles, Thomas Gibson, the K-State big man, he's making a nice adjustment in-game, isn't he?
Yeah, I love that. I love to see young players make in-game adjustments, kind of learning from your mistakes. First possession of the game, he tries to go inside against the bigger, stronger Ridley. He travels, he couldn't get his footwork down, so this time he says, okay, I can't shoot over you in the post, so I'm going to step out, create some space. You're going to have to come out and play me, and now eBay's in the game, goes into his body, up takes the shot blocker, eBay takes the step forward, and then Gibson takes the step through, able to finish. Love the in-game adjustments of Thomas Gibson.
And not easy against Texas, a team with some legitimate size and shot blocking ability, one of the better shot blocking teams in the country.
Yeah, Texas averages 6.6 blocks per game, which is fifth in the nation coming into tonight's game. So not an easy task, especially for a guy, Gibson, who is an undersized five-man on this roster. He's truly a power forward, but he's a non-athletic guy.
Cam Ridley back in, trying to make a move against Gibson. He scores.
Cam really, really, he's in better shape this year, can play longer stretches, trimmed up his body, got more muscular, has great hands and a soft touch around the basket.
Biggest lead for either team. It's four in a very close first half. Foster stepped through and scores off the glass.
Foster can score in so many ways. His shooting percentages aren't great, but he's really just a natural scorer. 14 points a game. Has to be mentioned as one of the best, if not the best. Joel Embiid is the best in the league, but Marcus Foster making a case.
Yeah, he's made a big impact. Holmes had his shot blocked. Jonathan Holmes been pretty quiet in this one. Foster throws the lob and the finish by Owundu.
I love it. Marcus Foster with his head up, always in attack mode. Usually looks to get to the basket or score for himself, but finds Owundu running the lane.
And you think for the two Texas kids coming back, not exactly home, but to their home state to play, that's pretty big play for them.
Well, I think it's important for, it's definitely important for Foster, Owundu, and Gibson, guys that weren't really recruited by the University of Texas, to play well here in their home state. And here goes Foster using that pick, comes off tight. Love the patience that he shows, and then gets a little bit extra arc on that shot, and then has his eyes up and finds the athlete, Wesley Owundu, on the dunk as he gives the signal to his freshman partner and then is able to throw it down.
Well, you were a kid who grew up in Southern California, went away to Arizona to play. I remember you telling me about how much it meant to you when you came back to play UCLA, play USC.
My most important games were those two, always coming back home to LA. I actually played my best basketball against the Bruins over my career. And for Foster, Owundu, and Gibson, as much as they might not say it because they'll probably be politically correct in the media, but on the inside, you know they want to play well here at UT.
Little 7-0 run. Ridley can't end it. Here come the Wildcats. Owundu in the open court again, draws the foul. Kansas State almost beating Texas at its own game, getting out of the open court running.
Yeah, and that's the advantage of having a guy like Foster in the lineup. You wouldn't say there's a true point guard on the floor for K-State right now. Will Spradlin kind of a combo, but Foster can handle the ball so well. We've seen the excellent vision, and he finds a Owundu again running the lane.
The freshman from Houston misses the first of two. Super Tuesday continues tonight on ESPN at 9 Eastern. Kentucky against Texas A&M. Remember, the Aggies wasn't too long ago. They went into Rupp and beat Kentucky. Also live on Watch ESPN.
Kentucky, a team that I feel is slowly but surely figuring it out. They're a potentially dangerous team probably by the end of February and on into March.
And they got a Texas flavor on that Kentucky team.
Julius Randle, the Harrison twins.
Longhorns, half-court offense has been real quiet. There's Isaiah Taylor.
Not an easy shot by any means, but it's a shot that most point guards, if not all guards, should have in their repertoire. Just a little floater there off the glass at an angle.
There's Gibson down low.
I mentioned earlier that Ridley's in better shape. So is Thomas Gibson. Those shoulders look bigger than they were last year, really more muscular. Got excellent position on the block there.
This is a heck of a physical matchup. Ridley and Gibson going back and forth.
I love it. And I love the fact that their teammates are looking for him on the inside. Sometimes college guys get too caught up in perimeter games, one-on-one. But when you got two guys down low that can finish, keep giving them the basketball.
Well, they're trying to get it to Gibson. Foster is left open. Gibson tried to tap it off the backboard, saves the possession. Spradlin. Gibson, more hustle from the big man. He also got poked, I think, in the face, the eye. Play goes on.
This is unlike a Texas team this year. Texas, one of the best rebounding teams in the country. Top 20 in rebounding margin, but are getting slammed on the offensive glass.
Here's a lob on this end. And the spectacular finish for the Longhorns and DeMarcus Croker. Well, after the K-State run. The Longhorns have answered. The students who are here tonight, excited about that one. Nice finish at the rim.
Today at the shoot-around, just saying that he was one of the hardest workers that we've had in my history as the coach here, as the Longhorns coach. And we have to get back to having guys like that. And they may not have that talent, but he wants the guys with the work ethic of Kevin Durant when he's looking for recruits.
Foster traveled. K-State commits a turnover that sends us to another timeout. Big 12 basketball, we're going to have games like this all year long. Beautiful night in Austin. Longhorns lead by one. Sounds pretty enticing. Thank you, Chris. 29-28, Texas with the lead over 22nd-ranked Kansas State. Talking about getting near the midway point of conference play, hard to believe. What are your impressions about halfway through the Big 12?
Man, I just feel it's such a hard league. It's hard to go on the road and get wins. Iowa State, who was undefeated at 14-0, has now lost three in a row. Baylor, who was in the top 10 at one point 2 weeks ago, has now dropped, I believe, three in a row. But the league is going to get six or seven. It's just a deep, balanced league. And you wouldn't say it has the star power. I know Wiggins and Smart and Embiid, but I think when you look at these two teams right here, they're doing it with young guys on their roster. Texas has 10 scholarship players, and only one of those guys is an upperclassman. So I think it's going to be a league that's very good for a long time to come.
Croker launches the three. It wouldn't do. Defensive rebound. Thomas back in off the bench for K-State, pulls up, hits the two.
Very much under control right there, smooth, got to his sweet spot at about 15 feet, didn't try to rush it. Nice play by the freshman.
If he hits that shot consistently, he's going to be a heck of a player. Owundu went for the steal, didn't get it. And the defense really never recovered with the foul.
And as we see this play unfold right here, you love the spin move and then the unselfishness after the rotation to find Ridley just planted underneath the basket for the Longhorns. The Longhorns are dominating in the paint. They are 10 for 14 on field goals inside of the paint. And Bruce Weber felt that that was going to be his biggest concern about this game, the size of this Longhorn team.
And that's been the strength of Texas in this one. Ridley makes the free throw, so he's having a big half. Texas, final 2 minutes and a half, leading K-State by two. Devon Thomas. Foster off a screen. That's a whistle and a foul against the Wildcats. They're calling Southwell with the illegal screen.
And I think Texas really got lucky right there because Holland really made a mistake. Against a guy like Foster, you have to trail him off those screens. And he went to cut that screen, and they called Southwell for the moving pick. But I didn't see much of one.
Marcus Holland bringing the ball up against Foster. You see K-State does switch a lot on defense. Holland might have gotten away with a little push off there. Then Johnson comes out for help, commits the foul.
Holland sold that one, though. DJ Johnson did a pretty good job of moving his feet, showing his hands right there, moving laterally. But Holland, when he took the hit, sold the contact.
Johnson committed the foul. He goes to the bench. Texas now in the bonus. One-on-one free throws for DeMarcus Holland. Neither of these teams particularly good at the free throw line. Holland earns the second.
Holland's a guy that a lot of young players, high school players, can really learn from. Not a tremendously great threat on the offensive end, but defense got him on the floor as a freshman. And it's enabled him to be in the starting lineup because he's an excellent defender. Most high school guys think that the way to get on the floor as a freshman in college is because they can score the basketball. But if you look at this K-State roster, besides Foster, these guys, Owundu and Johnson, they were getting on the floor because they're excellent defenders.
Good look from Foster. Southwell, though, missed the open three. Felix wants to push. Felix never stopped. He scores off the glass. Biggest lead for Texas. 11-2 run, loudest it's been in the Erwin Center.
Let's see if they can get Gibson a touch. He's been their best offensive player in the first half.
The Wendu from that elbow area, no good. And now a timeout, shot clock is off. Texas can get organized for a final look.
Dave, Kansas State coming off sharing that conference title last year with KU, have really hung their hat on the defensive end this year. If you look at those numbers, the opponent's points per game, 59.9, and opponent's three-point percentage, those are Big 12 leaders right there. The Indiana Pacers, the best team in the NBA, 88.3 and 32% from the three-point line. Those numbers lead the NBA. So you want a formula for success on how to win basketball games? That's the formula. Do it with defense. That's what the Pacers have bought into. They don't outscore teams, but they outwork teams on the defensive end, and that's what this Kansas State team is really built on.
And I think part of what makes that really impressive, that comparison, what K-State's doing on defense, is what you were talking about. They're integrating young players who are playing defense like that.
The hardest thing, I coached at the University of Arizona, one of the hardest things to teach a freshman is to learn how to play defense, because in high school, they're usually these guys are heavily relied upon to be the main scorer on their team. So now you bring in, with each of these teams, four freshmen that are buying in to defense right away to get on the floor. Impressive.
Texas trying to hold for the final shot. Felix against Thomas. Final 10 seconds. Good pass. Ridley down low. Offensive foul. But Ridley knocked the defender down, and he went sprawling to the court. Foul against the Longhorns.
And that was excellent rotation there by Foster. But as we see the replay, Ridley lowers his shoulder and levels Foster to the ground. But an excellent job. And we spoke about the defense and about being a freshman. Not a lot of guys willing to sacrifice their body and rotate on a guy that has about 85 pounds on him.
So 6 seconds, plenty of time. Thomas trying to go all the way. Gibson scores at the buzzer. So that's a heck of a turnaround. Texas trying to hold for the final shot. Instead, it's the Wildcats who get the basket.
And there's where Javon Thomas is the difference maker. The speed, the athleticism. He's only been eligible since December 21st, but they can give it to him on the run. He draws eBay, dishes it off to his big man, Thomas Gibson, who's able to finish at the buzzer, and K-State able to cut that lead to 4. But that's the dynamic that Javon Thomas brings to this Wildcat team.
Yeah, automatically, end of half, end of game, the officials take a look. They've already said thumbs up. Basket counts. Texas with the 4-point lead. Now Chris, Seth, and Jay in the studio.
Both young men doing an excellent job of playing with their back to the basket and contributing in the painted area.
Now Gibson had 10 to lead K-State. Ridley had 12 to lead Texas. Kansas State got a bucket right at the buzzer at the end of the first half, and they have the ball to start the second half. Trying for a league road win. Gibson, the shot fake got Ridley in the air, then he lost it on the way up. Taylor on the attack, draws a foul. Foul against Spradling in the open court.
Gibson had the move that he wanted. He had him set up going to the middle, and he up faked Ridley out of his stance, but just couldn't hold on to the basketball.
And Texas inbounds. Felix pull up for a little guy. He does a nice job of finding space on the offensive end.
Yeah, but one thing about being small, Javon Felix has long arms, 6'6" wingspan and big hands. And there he's able to use some athleticism and elevate on the pull-up jumper.
Rick Barnes says he just has a knack for scoring. Good offensive player. Spradling dribbles out of the corner. Pass was deflected. Nice look, though, off the deflection to Gibson with the foul. Pretty heads-up play by Will Spradling.
Will Spradling has an unbelievable assist-to-turnover ratio. Almost turned it over, stayed with it. Still had his head up and then able to find the open Gibson.
Second foul against Ridley. So Gibson at the line. Texas kid coming back to play in Austin.
And there's so much talent in the state of Texas. And maybe one reason why the Longhorns have been down in the last year or so, you know, they had went to 14 straight NCAA tournaments before going 16 and 18, is the talent that's got out of the state of Texas. Julius Randle at Kentucky, Matt Jones at Duke, Rashid Suleiman at Duke, And then in the next year's incoming class of freshmen, Justice Winslow, Justin Jackson, Emmanuel Moutier, all of them choosing other schools besides the Longhorns.
Taylor, wild shot, ball caroms around, and Holmes came away with it, then committed to travel. And the point really is, Texas has become such a great state for high school basketball. The Longhorns have not done a great job these last few years keeping the elite talents at home.
And now they are in on the top unsigned senior in the class of 2014, big man Miles Turner. But it's going to be a fight down to the end with Kansas, Kentucky, Oklahoma State, and Duke all still in the mix. But Miles Turner, an elite talent, a guy that can really take this program back to the Final Four, Elite Eights, winning Big 12 championships, and that's where Rick Barnes wants to be.
Holmes almost traveled again.
But I really think in this recruiting class of freshmen that he has in Croker and Walker and Yancey and Isaiah Taylor, he found guys that really fit his system and style of play. They want to go up and down. These are team-first guys, guys that live in the gym, and those are the guys that Rick Barnes is concentrating on getting into the Longhorns program.
Jonathan Holmes working hard here in the second half on the glass. Got Texas a longer possession, and the Longhorns are a very young team. See the rebound numbers for Holmes. Has the most experience of anybody on this team. Another opportunity. Felix hits from the free throw line.
Long shots equal long rebounds, and Javon Felix takes advantage of that opportunity there.
eBay in for Ridley down low. Gibson against the shot blocker, who definitely altered that shot. Felix, quick move off the dribble. Awundu got the hand up there to block the shot. Spradling out of the open court. Spradling out of bounds. Turnover K-State. We're talking about that roster, the makeup of this Texas Longhorns team that has turned things around this year. Not a single senior, just a couple juniors. And really, Holmes, the junior, contributes the most. Then all the sophomores and freshmen.
And Holmes is the only upperclassman on scholarship on that breakdown there. And the four freshmen on this roster are playing 41% of the minutes, so they're contributing at a high level, as are the four freshmen for Kansas State.
So you get the good with the freshmen, and then sometimes you get that. Isaiah Taylor knows that was not very well done. Javon Thomas, the freshman for the Wildcats, into this game. 5-point lead for Texas. K-State gets the ball back. And it's almost like the first step for the Longhorns, Miles, was what you were talking about, getting the culture back to where Rick Barnes wants it, the dedication to the program. They do have to get some of that elite talent here, though. Foster, nice soft roll for the kid from Wichita Falls.
Well, they lost their top four scorers from last year, Sheldon McClellan, Mike Kabongo, Julian Lewis, and Ioannis Papapetru, who turned pro. Papapetru's the guy that Rick Barnes really said helped change that culture in the spring before he decided to turn pro and sign in his home country of Greece. But Papapetru was one of the hardest workers. He would have been the leading returning scorer and fit in perfectly with this group of Longhorns.
Foster fouled by Isaiah Taylor. Taylor's first personal. And a similar story, I think, with K-State. Rodney Magruder, all Big 12 performer, left. And then Angel Rodriguez, I don't think anybody expected him to leave. He was a heck of a point guard last year for Bruce Weber. He was gone.
Jordan Henriquez, he was a shot blocker in the middle. But Angel Rodriguez, Coach Weber felt that they had end of the year meetings and that everything was okay, and then all of a sudden Angel Rodriguez felt it wasn't the right place or whatever he wanted to do, and he went back home, and he's going to be suited up for Jim Larrañaga next year in the Miami Hurricanes uniform.
Thomas Gibson's got 15. K-State down by one. Another ultra competitive game in the Big 12. Holland tried to get the ball inside to eBay.
You see K-State, they're content to let you pass around the perimeter. They want to protect the paint and make you shoot contested jump shots.
There's Felix into the lane. The runner short. Contested for sure by the Wildcats. Then Nito Williams almost lost the ball. Thomas, he saw Gibson early. Got the position down low. Missed the shot. Holland in the open court, sloppy ball handling by DeMarcus Holland. And I think Texas did get the timeout. So not a jump ball. The Longhorns call the timeout. to save the possession. They've got three left with 15:40 to go. Texas at home leads by one.
That won't be easy for the Cuse. In the Carrier Dome, Jim Larranaga and his squad played them to a 49-45 basketball game. Trevor Cooney will need to knock down some shots. C.J. Fair will need to be big going on the road.
How do you stop that? Cameron Ridley, so skilled for a guy his size, and Ridley gets the rejection of Foster, who's then fouled by Martez Walker.
And that block by Ridley was excellent. He just kind of went two hands straight up, moved his feet, and kept that basketball in bounds. I know Foster took the hit on his face, but we got a good one here in Austin.
Foul shots, though, from the seated position.
I think he still wishes he was on break.
Yeah, although the kids, I think, are having a good time back at a hoops game here in Austin. Great college town. Cameron Ridley, who has stepped up his game for the Longhorns in Big 12 play. He and Gibson having quite a battle here. 42-39, Texas with the lead. Dave Fleming, Miles Simon from the Erwin Center. There's Gibson against Ridley. Little up fake, and Ridley, more good defense.
And you see that time, Ridley kept moving his feet after the up fake, not allowing the step through by Gibson.
Felix and Ridley have dominated the scoring for the Longhorns, each with 14. Felix is on the bench at the moment. They get Ridley a touch. Shot clock under 10.
Taylor missed Ridley on the slip.
Marcus Holland to the basket, missed the layup. Williams saved it right to Texas. Layup good.
You never save the basketball underneath the opposing team's hoop. You kind of let that go, and I know he's trying to make a hustle play right there, but you have to be more aware unless you can absolutely see your teammate and throw it to him. And you know Williams cost his team a bucket there.
Yeah, that led to a very easy basket. Wesley Owundu.
Holland doing an excellent job on Foster, denying, making everything tough on him. Foster 3-for-8 from the field, leading scorer for the Wildcats.
Thomas, there's Foster, shot clock at 5, air ball.
And post guys, just like guarding on the perimeter, you have to keep moving your feet in the post because the offensive guy doesn't stop moving. The up and under, Ridley slides over to his left and affects that shot, causing Gibson to miss. Excellent job by the big fella Cameron Ridley in staying active.
14 points, 5 rebounds, plenty of good defense. Longhorns' lead is 5. Their biggest lead in this game, 6. This has been very closely played all the way through. Holland picked up that pivot foot. Another travel on Texas.
Holland anticipated a pass that he wanted to make, but when the pass wasn't there, he dragged his foot. A lot of times when you come off those dribble handoffs or on-ball screens, young players across can keep that dribble alive. Don't pick it up. See how they'll just go under on Thomas, even daring to shoot just 17 footers.
Shane Southwell back in. A crossover move, hits the jumper.
And I was going to say that's probably a little bit too much dribbling, not enough motion for Bruce Weber's liking, but Southwell just able to create enough separation. He's really gained a lot more confidence in his shooting over the last month.
And he should be able to take advantage of that matchup if Lambert is matched up with him. Isaiah Taylor was fouled by Thomas, who cannot believe the whistle, his second personal. Fresh shot clock for the Longhorns. Felix also comes back in for Texas. He's had a nice scoring game and gets a quick touch. Ron Felix from New Orleans. Took a Wundu off the dribble, gets to the free throw line. First first foul on Wesley Owundu. Felix, good shooter, good free throw shooter.
Felix originally from Louisiana, from New Orleans, St. Augustine's High School. Same high school as one of my former teammates, Eugene Edgerson. St. Aug's a powerhouse down there. Felix actually had to relocate for 4 months to the Atlanta area due to Hurricane Katrina when he was a youngster.
Came back to New Orleans, as so many did. And he's a New Orleans guy through and through. Made one of two free throws.
But he's really playing much better as being able to play off the ball this year, having a guy like Taylor who can run the show, and Felix able to just score the basketball. As you can see, Shane Southwell now kind of heating up from the mid-range, taking advantage of the matchup that he has.
Yeah, that's that advantage he gets, right? When he can guard a big man and force the big man to guard him, he usually takes advantage of that.
Yeah, Lambert not as comfortable guarding on the perimeter.
Felix beautifully done along two.
Felix has had a couple big scoring. I had 28 points against Oklahoma off the bench, and there's Javon Thomas just making a nice play for his team, getting 2 feet in the paint and dropping that dime to Thomas Gibson.
Now the basket went. They called a foul against Ridley. Gibson sort of hung on to the rim, and then the ball went through the hoop. So they got some things to sort out here. Great look from Javon Thomas. Found Gibson. The dunk went in. Whistle and a foul. And I think they're going to talk about this one as we go to break.
And there you see the nice pass, and Gibson going up strong before the big fella can get there. Hangs on the rim.
All right, Chris, thanks. 2-point lead for Texas, 47-45. Thomas Gibson, you saw the play before we went to break. Here's what happened. The dish from Thomas, Gibson goes up, Ridley commits the foul. The officials will count the basket because Gibson hung on the rim. He got fouled. He was off balance. He was hanging on the rim to protect himself. The ball never hit him as it came down. It went straight through the basket. So even though he's hanging on it, he's allowed to do it in that instance. Count the basket plus a free throw.
And they absolutely got that call right.
They did.
You and I talked about it during the timeout. Gibson was definitely doing it to protect himself from fouling, because you can also see his body momentum was swinging forward in that instance.
So big play in a lot of ways, 3-point play down to a 1-point lead, plus Ridley goes to the bench. Cam Ridley's got 3 personal fouls now. And he has been about the most effective player on the court for Texas.
On both ends of the floor, affecting things on the defensive end, but offensively he's been a force. Holmes is the guy that really needs to pick it up.
Yeah, no kidding. Maybe a move like that will get him going.
Holmes is the leading scorer on this team, but yet he only takes the 4th most field goal attempts. He's almost a guy that you feel should be more aggressive on the offensive end, looking for a shot, trying to score and get this young team going.
Foster. Now Gibson posting up. That's a kickball. Jonathan Holmes, the junior from San Antonio, the guy Miles is talking about, 13 plus a game, just 4 so far in this one. But Texas does not rely on a scoring star. They don't have anybody in the top 15 in the Big 12 in scoring.
Yeah, it's more of just a balanced effort. It's a different guy each night. You see Felix tonight having the big numbers. Ridley's been putting up good numbers as of late. But Jonathan Holmes is a guy coming off 23 points against Iowa State. Can do it inside and out.
Marcus Foster. Spradling followed the miss, and he got decked. Forearm right to his face. It was unintentional, but a hard foul. Spradling hit the ground. And slow to get up. Man, that hurt.
Will Spradling, as tough as they come, he's coming in here right out of your picture to grab that. There's no block out, and eBay catches him right across his face.
Man, so Will Spradling, again, not intentional from Prince eBay, but a very hard foul. Spradling's nose took the worst of it.
I think they got a little blood coming out of the nose there. They'll get that stopped up, and I don't imagine that we'll see Will Spradling out of this game for very long.
6 points, has hit a couple of threes. Exactly what Bruce Weber wants from him. Just hit 3, maybe 4 jumpers a game. Play his typically solid floor game. Play good defense.
Well, let's remember, let's go back to Javon Thomas is really the only pure point guard on this roster. Will Spradling, because Thomas didn't become eligible till December 21st, Spradling kind of playing out of position. They had anticipated Angel Rodriguez still being on the roster this coming season. So Spradling had to guard on the ball, guard point guards, run the team, and do so many things. I think that took away from his offense a lot in the first couple months of the season. He's still trying to find a rhythm on that end.
He's the last guy remaining. Remember, almost 4 years ago now, Frank Martin in Kansas State had such a good team, went all the way to the Elite Eight. He was on that team, the last guy from that Elite Eight squad.
Jacob Pullen, Danny Clemente.
K-State has some big dreams again this season. Playing well, top 25 team now, and getting better. Spradling still on the bench. The entry pass, Gibson with a good catch. Missed the layup. A whistle.
And that may have been Gibson's easiest look of the night. A great entry pass from Javon Thomas. Thomas has delivered some nice dimes, two especially in this half, to Gibson that he hasn't been able to finish.
A Texas player was out of bounds touching the ball. So K-State. Southwell, the defense just backed off. Southwell was wide open. Foster, Thomas looking for his teammate again. Here's Thomas off the dribble attack. eBay definitely impacted that shot. Wildcats keep the ball.
Offensive rebounds are killing Texas.
Gibson sticking with it. Thomas Gibson having a big game.
And he almost did too much, Dave. He had the right hand lane. He went away from it because he wanted to get back to his strong hand. But excellent footwork to keep his pivot foot down and finish.
On that trip down, Kansas State got five shots up. So five shots, they finally made one.
Percentages say you're probably going to score.
Yes. Well, a nice effort by DeMarcus Holland. Baseline couldn't finish with the dunk, but he does draw the foul.
And there you see, he had the right hand drop step right there, but he up fakes, comes back to his left with the soft touch. eBay just jumping all over the place. Got to stay down a little bit better if you're Prince eBay, but Thomas Gibson showing some great work in the post area.
Holland has shared the ball, has not scored the ball in this game. Misses the first of two free throws. He does have five assists. Thomas Gibson, one thing I like about his game, that's his first foul committed. So he plays pretty tough defense and does not usually foul.
Well, Bruce Weber told us one thing. The reason he's not fouling more, because he's in better condition. He can play longer stretches in a game without committing stupid fouls, dumb fouls when you're tired. And being really their best and only post presence makes a big difference for this team. There you see him on the offensive glass as Foster couldn't finish.
There's Taylor in the open court. Wildcats hustled back, prevented the layup, but Texas keeps it. Taylor again, baseline. Rebound Foster.
No numbers.
Fans getting on Marcus Foster a little bit. Air ball to jumper earlier in this second half. Gibson sets the screen for Southwell. eBay challenge, committed the foul.
Southwell plays the power forward spot on this team. But he's more like a small forward or a shooting guard, because he faces up, he handles the ball, he doesn't really play with his back to the basket too much. But there he's able to use the side pick and roll, get to the 15-foot mark and knock down, and sorry, get to the foul line.
Third foul against eBay. Southwell makes the first. DJ Johnson, sophomore from St. Louis, will give Gibson a rest. Thomas Gibson playing very hard tonight. Southwell made them both. 15 lead changes in this one with still 9 minutes to go.
Thomas is a pest on that basketball. He makes you work.
eBay sets a screen and Thomas fights right through it. Taylor runner, short tip, no good. Thomas now with the lead, bounce pass. What a pass. Owundu scores.
And that was a great pass, because that wasn't an easy pass. Off the bounce with one hand to deliver it right on time to Owundu.
and a window, and I know it looked awkward. I love the fact that the refs didn't call a travel there, because sometimes when things don't look the way they're supposed to, like a one-deuce Euro step right there because he didn't take a dribble, doesn't mean that it's a travel.
9-2 run, and this matches the biggest lead all game for K-State. On the baseline, Holmes has just been off the mark on the offensive end. Longhorns play some volleyball.
I think they got to go back to Felix. He's had the hot hand.
Longhorns have missed 6 shots in a row. Now make it 7. Another tip ball. Felix could not use the glass. Tip no good. Texas just cannot get a shot to go down right now. Foster in transition. Wild shot. Owundu had it stripped away. So it's getting a little ragged. That's a reach-in foul against Owundu. Taylor on the floor.
Javon Thomas, the freshman from Queens, New York, showing some of that street ball savvy. Look at his eyes up. Delivers it on target. 2 steps, no travel, finish. K-State up by 4.
Austin, the capital city in this state, the home of the University of Texas. Kansas State with a 3-point lead, 7:21 to go. Super Tuesday continues tonight on ESPN at 9. Kentucky hosting Texas A&M. Live on ESPN, also on Watch ESPN at 9 Eastern.
Julius Randle, a Texas kid. He's a double-double machine. Hit his first 3 of the season last game. But he's just so special. He's a big-time NBA body and a talent. But I think that Kentucky team, the Harrison brothers, are slowly but surely figuring out. James Young is smooth on the wing. If they can get some contributions from Poitras off the bench, John Calipari's team can make a lot of noise.
And that SEC, which has been beleaguered in a way for a lack of high-level teams. Florida's playing really well. Kentucky playing a whole lot better. This Big 12, though, there's been no doubt from the start of the year about the strength of this conference. Texas with the ball at home, down by 3.
And now we see Will Spradling back in the game with the little nose plug in to stop the bleeding. I told you he wouldn't be out for very long. But the Longhorns right now, they need to establish Cameron Ridley in the post against DJ Johnson.
Yeah. He's back in. He just got fouled. I think that's exactly what they were looking to do, Miles. Johnson commits his second personal.
DJ Johnson is second. 6 team fouls.
Holland the inbounder. Felix trying to spring free. Ridley with the catch. Had it stripped away by Thomas. Ridley was getting him ready to go dunk the ball. Thomas layup no good. Johnson over the back.
Ridley made one of the few mistakes that he's made all night. He didn't need to bring that basketball down. He didn't need to power up. He's only 2 feet away from the rim. When he caught the inbounds pass, just lay it up. He brought it down, put it on the floor, and tried to crab dribble. And Javon Thomas right there, the little fella, was there to take it.
Both teams in the bonus now. And that was a costly layup missed by Javon Thomas, because not only did he miss the 2 points, his teammate commits the foul. Johnson goes to the bench now. And free throws created, 1-1 opportunity for the Longhorns and Martez Walker. And I think the officials just want to make sure that they have the right free throw shooter, so they can go to the monitor to review that, make sure the right free throw shooter's at the line. And we'll take a look ourselves.
And that should be Holland going to the line.
Yep, you're right. They did not have the correct shooter. So DeMarcus Holland should be the guy at the free throw line. Didn't take it long. 1 quick look. And now it'll be Holland shooting the 1-1.
Holland only a 56%er. I think they tried to get Martez Walker in there. Martez Walker's a guy that shoots that 6-for-8 on the season, a little bit better shooter than Holland.
Longhorns as a team, 5 of 10 at the line in this game. Holland earns his second. Every win in the Big 12 Conference precious this year. Final 7 minutes, and we got a good one in Austin. 1-point game. Southwell challenged by Ridley. Good defense from the big man. I think for the most part, Miles, Kansas State's done a good job getting back in transition defense.
Yeah, especially here in the second half, making Texas play in the half court. And that's really given the Longhorns problems.
Javon Felix, tough runner. Texas back up by one. Bradley with the bloody nose. Southwell challenged on the three and hits it anyway.
But you know who that was created by? Javon Thomas. Javon Thomas should get the hockey assist on that. He had the ball on the right-hand side of the floor. Penetrated, got 2 feet in the paint, kicks to Spradling. And there you see the great touch pass by Holmes and draws the foul. But as we go back, we look at this three-point shot by Southwell. It all started with Javon Thomas in the corner. Pump fakes, penetrates, 2 feet in the paint. Then Spradling with the heads-up touch pass to Shane Southwell before the rotation can get there. Excellent job by the Kansas State Wildcats of playing unselfishly.
Cam Ridley missed the chance for the three-point play. Does get the two free throws. The foul is against Spradling. Easy to be impressed by this kid, the sophomore from Houston, big-time player in high school, kind of an up-and-down freshman year, has taken a big leap forward. Tie game once again. Gibson had the ball go right through his hands.
Got a mismatch. Holmes trying to post up Spradling right now. Let's see if Southwell and Spradling can get the switch.
And still Spradling on Holmes.
See, this is the biggest difference between the NBA and college. In a mismatch like that in the NBA, they always find it.
The leagues short on the pull-up, so they never did get Holmes a touch.
It's hard because there's so much help side in college basketball. Guys can be behind. There's not the isolation opportunities.
Thomas had the pass deflected, but K-State keeps it. Under five to go.
I think Thomas Gibson has to get a touch on this possession.
Shot clock. He does get the touch and scores from Spradling. And now a very sloppy pass. Owundu is fouled. Holmes just threw it right to Wesley Owundu and then commits the foul.
Well, first, two of the most experienced players on the K-State roster were perfectly in sync on the pick and roll, on the pick and roll opportunity. Gibson presents himself. Spradling delivers a perfect pass. Gibson doesn't put it on the floor and lays it in. And then the poor job on the inbounds pass. Felix is playing the point guard spot in this case because Taylor's out of the game. And now you see the substitution. Now they put in the natural point guard coming in for Felix. But Felix stopped his cut there. That's not necessarily Holmes's fault. He threw it to where he thought Felix was going to be.
Owundu missed the first, made the second. Wesley Owundu just one of four at the free throw line, but K-State, the Wildcats up by three. Taylor on the attack. Tough shot, no good. Tip up, spins down. I think they'll credit Walker with the basket. Now Thomas goes to the basket, had it blocked out of bounds.
Boy, is he quick.
He
Did
is.
You see that hesitation crossover, and he was at the rim before any Texas defender knew they were lucky to be able to get there. Look at this hesitation. Crossover, boom. And he's in the gap. He's in the seam. But luckily, Ridley has the long arms and able to knock the ball out of bounds.
Yeah, that was a great recovery for the big man, Cam Ridley. Spradling now calls a timeout to prevent the turnover. Nothing easy in this game on either side, even just getting the ball in bounds.
Dave, and I think you and I talked about it earlier today. We've seen this is now our third time seeing K-State this year.
The first time was without Javon Thomas, but he looks better and better each time we see him. And imagine when he gets an off-season strength and conditioning program.
Yeah, I think it's a point worth making. Javon Thomas was not eligible to practice with this Kansas State team for the first semester of the year. Just started practicing really around the holiday time, so still trying to get integrated with his teammates. He can be a difference maker, though.
And he enrolled last February, but he wasn't able to practice with the team, couldn't work with the strength and conditioning coach. All he could do was work out on his own in the gym by himself with a manager rebounding for him. But once he's able to practice some more. He missed all the crucial practices, the fundamental stuff that you get at late September when real practices start and they go 2.5-3 hours.
Not a perfect player, not a great shooter, but does a lot of things well. He's got the ball and he'll feed Gibson against Ridley. That quick spin move, Ridley didn't see it coming, but he managed to alter the shot anyway. Gibson had a point blank look. That is a missed opportunity for K-State.
Ridley needs to get a touch.
Taylor looking for some help after he picked up the dribble. Shot clock down to 8.
Holmes doesn't seem like he wants the basketball here in the second half.
Ridley finally does get a touch and scores. Texas back up by 1. 18 for the big man.
Let the big fellas go after it. Go right back to Gibson. Let him try to have an answer. He's been their most effective offensive player.
Southwell. Gibson's going to come out to set a screen, but they never used it. K-State's got to go. Southwell, the high-arcing three. Gibson had his hands on it. A whistle and a foul against the Longhorns. And if that's against Ridley, it's his fourth. It is. Big moment in this game. He's dominated inside. He's got 4 fouls. Final 2:50 coming up from Austin. It's a 1-point game. Dave Fleming, Miles Simon in Austin, Texas with a 1-point lead. Final 2:50 to go in this Big 12 matchup. A Big 12 matchup dominated by the big guys. Cameron Ridley for the Longhorns, Thomas Gibson for the Wildcats.
Yeah, it's been a tremendous. These guys have a lot of beef down low, but both of them are improved back to the basket players. Ridley really making a tremendous jump in his sophomore year. But I love the fact that these guys are getting touches, their teammates believe in them, and then they're finishing around the basket.
Cameron Ridley, though, that last sequence, wild shot, just really a heave from Kansas State. But then on the offensive glass, Gibson grabbed the ball, and Ridley committed his 4th personal foul. So one more, and he's out. 1-1 situation for Thomas Gibson, the 71% free throw shooter. Earns the 2nd, also matches his career high.
Kansas State winning the rebounding battle against a Texas team that's 19th in the country in rebounding margin. But they're up 34-33, including 16 offensive boards as Thomas Gibson gets the Texas roll. He's a Texas kid.
So a little home cooking for the guy who went out of state for his college career and is leading the charge for the Wildcats in this one. Ridley posting up. They couldn't get in the ball. K-State back in front by 1.
Taylor has to look to be more aggressive off those picks. He's kind of just coming off and just looking to pass.
The leaks. Shot clock winding down. Quick crossover move and great defense. Southwell blocked the shot out of bounds. Did they call a foul? They did. They called a foul against Southwell, who cannot believe it. That's his 2nd personal. It means free throws for the Longhorns.
Well, watch Felix jump into him. Felix's shoulder actually hits Southwell, and then it looks like Southwell got all basketball on that.
That's a bad break for Kansas State.
I would tend to agree with Southwell on that call. Felix initiated the contact.
Takes advantage of it by hitting the 1st. Another tie. There just has been no separation in this game. Close from start to finish. Texas back in front. The 20th time in this game that the lead has changed hands. 10 different ties. Gibson sets a screen for Spradling. Gibson's got to get back closer to the basket.
Well, they're going to go high ball screen with Gibson here on the roll.
Thomas had it stripped away by Holmes. Holmes being chased by Southwell is fouled. Shooting for Jonathan Holmes.
And Dave, that's actually a really good foul by Shane Southwell, because the fans were ready to explode and get off their feet, especially with this lead, and Holmes was able to throw that down. But Southwell fouled him on the right shoulder, which prevented him from going up and dunking that basketball.
Holmes is a good free throw shooter. Misses the first of two. Jonathan Holmes up over 82% at the line for the year. Ridley will take a seat with the four fouls. They do lose something on the defensive end, though, with him out of the game. Protect him with the foul trouble.
Well, eBay's also a good shot blocker, but I feel that Ridley's done a better job against Gibson of moving his feet against Gibson's footwork.
Southwell gets Gibson a touchdown low against eBay with the right hand. eBay got the block. Bruce Weber saying no foul, play straight up defense here. Now a whistle and a timeout for Rick Barnes. That may well mean that Ridley can come back in the game on this offensive set.
The one advantage right there is that eBay prefers to block shots with his left hand. So Gibson goes to his weak hand, kind of lost that ball on the way up when he tried to go to that right hand jump hook. But Prince eBay with the long arms stayed down that time, moved his feet, excellent job on the defensive end.
It might have been a break for the Longhorns. You're right, Bruce Weber and company. We'll talk about this defensive possession. 62-60 Texas. Three timeouts remaining for the Wildcats, two left for the Longhorns. Texas in the double bonus, 10 team fouls against K-State. Still 1-1 free throws if Texas commits a foul. And the arrow favors the Longhorns. Every game in this league feels so important with the way that the first part of this conference season has played out. And this Big 12 conference, Kansas, of course, is playing so well. Predictably, the kings of this conference. Bill Self looking for a 10th consecutive Big 12 championship. But everybody after the Jayhawks is so tightly bunched.
Well, and a month ago, you wouldn't have said the Jayhawks were the best team in the conference. You wouldn't have said, thought that K-State would be 4-1, but teams continue to improve as the season goes along. Oklahoma State, who was maybe regarded as one of the favorites along with Kansas before the season, they lose Michael Collins, so their dynamic of their team changes. But it's such a deep league. It's a tough game every night. Teams kind of have to grind it out a little bit. Try to steal one on the road when you can and hold serve on your home court as much as possible.
And Kansas State has compiled that conference record without having to go on the road much. They lost at Kansas. They won at TCU. Trying to get one against a good Longhorns team here tonight. Texas ball up two out of the timeout.
Well, the first thing I want to do, I want to try to get Cameron Ridley a touch on the block. And if that play breaks down, I'm going high ball screen. Put the ball in Javon Felix's hands.
Ridley will set the screen for Taylor. Taylor trying to get him the ball. He does. Southwell against Ridley, who gives it up. Felix knows he needs to shoot. Felix with Thomas right on him. Tough shot is good. What a shot for Felix. K-State's got to hurry. Spradling hits the two, and Bruce Weber gets the quick timeout.
Well, that couldn't have been defended any better by Javon Thomas. That was just great offense by Javon Felix. Felix didn't want the pick. They go inside the post area right away. Southwell does a good job of walling up on the kickout. Look, Felix gives a peek at the shot clock. He says, I don't need it. He rejects the screen. Javon Thomas is right there with him. But a beautiful two-dribble pull-up by Felix.
I mean, I think you're right. You can't play defense any better than that.
You made him shoot a contested two-point jumper off the bounce. Excellent defense by the Wildcats. Better offense in that case by Felix.
So Texas is in a good position. They have the ball. 15-second difference. Game clock, shot clock. Bruce Weber setting up the defense. And you figure K-State doesn't feel like they need to foul.
No, they definitely don't need to foul. Not with 15 seconds difference. And I think if you're Bruce Weber, not that you feel happy that you have to go on defense, but that's the strongest suit of your team. If you feel you have to do something in this game, get a score or get a stop, I would say that he feels more comfortable with his team to get a stop.
And the message almost could be just play defense exactly like you did on that last possession and make them make another tough shot. They are going to set up some pressure here. Final 50 seconds, Longhorns have the ball.
And remember, Texas is not a great foul shooting team, only 66% on the season.
Felix, he's the leading scorer for the Longhorns in this one. Freshman Isaiah Taylor. Longhorns happy to work some clock here. Felix against Owundu, another tough shot, doesn't go, and Southwell snatches the rebound away.
Like I said, they got the stop.
Here comes Shane Southwell. Southwell fouled. And he'll shoot two free throws to try to tie the game with 15 seconds left. Bruce Weber did not elect to call the timeout after his team got the defensive rebound, and Southwell draws the foul.
And I love the fact that he didn't call the timeout because the Texas Longhorns were in a scramble defensively. A lot of coaches across the country want to get a set in, but you have confidence in your senior. Shane Southwell mishandles the ball, but gets the contact as he goes up through Ridley's arm and body to go to the foul line.
And big news, that's the fifth foul. Ridley is out of the game. The senior Southwell missed the first one. Well, I think with 15 seconds, you don't have to miss this one. You can try to make and set up your defense, commit a foul.
You absolutely want to make this free throw. Put the pressure on, try to get a steal. Steal first, a trap, and then foul.
Missed them both. Rebound Texas. And K-State now has to foul quickly. They do. Well, Southwell had a chance to tie by making both. He missed them both.
And see, I don't know if Spradling knows the free throw percentages. Felix is the best guy, 83%. I would have trapped Felix, tried to get it out of his hand for at least a couple seconds because there's a lot of time left in this game. Remember, at the end of the first half, Thomas went coast to coast, made a pass and a shot in 5 seconds.
Felix, 3 of 4 at the line. Good free throw shooter. Missed the first. That's a big miss for K-State. Before the second free throw, Bruce Weber wants to use a timeout. He's got one remaining now with 11.2 seconds left. In theory, even with a make here, you don't have to shoot a three, but I think by the time you get the ball up the court, Bruce Weber is going to tell his team we need to take a three-point shot.
Yeah, I think the best thing you want to do, put the ball in Javon Thomas's hands here. Let him, I think they love the dribble handoff action, which they got just a couple plays ago when Spradling was able to turn the corner, and they can add Southwell to be the screener there on a pop action for the three.
And one interesting thing we have not seen, and there's another nose problem. Spradling already had the bloody nose. Now this time Southwell getting some attention during the huddle. Marcus Foster has not been on the court for K-State down the stretch.
And he just checked into the game, so you must be aware of where he is on the floor.
Now the freshman, the leading scorer, there he is. 3 of 12 shooting, 8 points. It's been a tough night for Marcus Foster, but he's back in.
And end of game actions with 10 seconds or less is something that Bruce Weber works on in each and every shoot around for scenarios just like this.
Felix, one more free throw. It's a big one. And he missed it. So now K-State does not have to shoot the three. Shane Southwell gets a shot up and uses the backboard and scores. Under 5 seconds before Felix got the shot off, Texas calls a timeout. Tie game, 3.9 seconds on the clock.
And you see opposite strategies by each coach. No timeouts called by Bruce Weber, and it leads to a scramble situation. Nobody stops the basketball. Felix tries to do it at the last second, but he didn't want to foul, so he just gets his body in front and moves out of the way. And believe me, that's a very difficult shot by Shane Southwell going to the side, off balance, off of 1 foot. But Javon Felix, I feel, had an advantage there. Nobody was stopping him. In 2 seconds, he got all the way across half court and was ready to make a move and try to get to the basket. But now you're going to play against the best half court defense in the Big 12 on a set call with 3.9 left.
Yeah, very, very interesting. Two scenarios in a row where Bruce Weber let his team play, did not use the timeout. And Texas, on the other hand, calls the timeout to set up the offense with under 4 seconds left. So the two missed free throws were huge. Felix, who's a really good free throw shooter, even if he made just one of them, would have forced K-State to shoot a three. They took the two and tied the game.
And watch for K-State. They can switch 1 through 5 with 3.9 left. Gibson more than capable of switching on to Lambert or any one of the guards.
Taylor, the inbounder, gets it into Holland. Holland calls another timeout. Holland just did not want to shoot the ball, looked to the sideline, called a timeout after a full second had ticked off the clock.
Well, that was the problem with calling the initial timeout. You have a very young team in the Texas Longhorns that hasn't been in too many situations like this. End of game situations, tie basketball game. What do you do under pressure? Javon Felix was ready to take that basketball and try to get a good shot for the Longhorns. Now you're stuck with 1.9, which is plenty of time to get a shot. But as we mentioned, K-State, one of the best defensive teams in the country.
Time for an inbound pass, maybe one dribble, maybe two.
You can get one dribble and probably a pass. It's essentially 2 seconds on the clock. That's enough time to do that.
Well, Texas is out of timeouts now, though. 64-64, 1.9 seconds to go. Southwell hit the shot just a moment ago to tie the game.
Holmes and Felix should be the guys that should be the most active trying to get this basketball.
Again, Taylor's the inbounder. Holmes wins it! Hits the three and Texas wins! Finish. They do have to review to make sure, but I'm pretty sure.
Thomas Gibson just fell asleep. I think he was anticipating Felix coming back off the pick. Jonathan Holmes just pops right to the basketball, and that's within his wheelhouse right there to knock down the three, the high arcing shot. The follow-through helped. But in that case, Thomas Gibson has to be completely attached to Jonathan Holmes. And here you see the K-State bench, utter disappointment, a chance to steal one on the road for the K-State squad, but the Texas Longhorns holding serve at home.
For all the chaos of the final seconds, Texas hits the shot to win it. The Longhorns are 15-4. They beat another ranked team, second win over a ranked opponent here in Austin. Final score, Texas 67, K-State 64. For Miles Simon, Dave Fleming, for our entire crew, thanks for watching. Now we'll send you all the way across the world to the Australian Open.